Hey everyone, so a while back I made this video right here where I showed how to remove a black background from AI art in Affinity Photo, and that took a little bit of steps and it worked out great, but there's actually more steps for other things that I found out while doing more AI art. Not all of the backgrounds turn out to be super black, and so sometimes the background is not black, it's gray. Sometimes there's lots of different things in the background. Sometimes they put it on a t-shirt, and sometimes you may need to move words and things. So I'm going to show you all the different steps so that you can handle those problems that come up when you're doing AI art. And you may be thinking, well, can I just use the background remover in Ideogram? Now, here are some examples of what happens when you use the background remover. You can see it's not very good. So I'm going to show you how to make it nice and crisp and the backgrounds are removed and it's perfect for print on demand. And these are going to be done with the AI art that's already upscaled. So I've already upscaled these in DGB.lol, and so these are the right size already, and I'm going to show you how to remove the background for some of these touchy ones that are not just black backgrounds and get them ready for print on demand in the right size, the 4500 by 5400. So let's get into it. There's four different ways to do it, and I'm going to do the first one in Affinity Photo. All right, so here I am in Affinity Photo. I opened up a new one, but you may want to drag it into here, your PNG file, after you've scaled it up in DGB.lol or wherever you upscale it. And that's not what I do. Actually, what I do is I drag it into the app like this on my desktop, and then it opens it up in its own one like this. So that's the first step that I do. So you can see right here, this is the design that I have that was made by Ideogram. I think it looks really cool, but the downside is, even though I said black background, it's not black, it's kind of gray. So if I did the thing that I did in the other video and I, you know, removed white, inverted it and turned it to white, you would still see like a little bit of gray on here, and that's what would show up on the t-shirt too. So when you see your mock-up, it's not gonna do well. So what we're gonna do is actually make the background black. So in this case, if the background is not black, I'm gonna move my face over here so you can see what I'm doing. I'm gonna come in here, you see the background. I'm gonna do this right here. This is adjustments. I'm gonna click on it and you can see levels, and I'm gonna change the levels. So I'm gonna move the levels here so you can see it. This is the black. And so if I move this black level all the way past this spike here, kind of right here, you'll notice that now the background is black. But what happened is a lot of the other things changed colors. I'm gonna move the white as well so that it's lighter here, so you can see that's lighter. And sometimes you may need to move the gamma too for some of this lighter colors and stuff. So as long as this line right here, the black level, is past this spike, you'll see the spikes in different places. If it's gray, the lighter the gray is, the more this spike will be over here. And if it's more black, then you'll see the spike at the end here. But you'll notice now it is black. So I can do the steps that I did in that video. So those steps are, I'll remind you again, oh, actually, you have to do one more thing, and that is combine these two. Because if I'm just doing the steps without this, it's not going to work out. I actually have to click these two and merge visible. Actually, you don't have to click both of them because it's the only two that are visible, but I like to do that just so I know. Merge visible right here, and then I'm going to do that, and we're going to be working on the merged file. So this one right here, we can get rid of these two actually. Boom. And this is the merged file. So that's one thing that Affinity Photo does, is even though you made that adjustment, it keeps both of those layers, and you actually want to merge them to do the steps that I did. So I'll move me down here so you can see. All right, so now that we have this, we do the layer invert, right? So now that's white. And then I took filters and then colors and erase white paper. Boom, so you can see it's there. And now I can invert it again. And there you go, nice and crisp. Took out that black background, and I'm gonna make it the right size with the document size here. Resize canvas, click this middle, uncheck that lock, do 4500, and then hit tab, 5400, hit resize, and you can see it's a lot bigger, right? Because we did the upscale where it's 6 times, so it's bigger than the 4500. Click on this right here, make sure that's selected, and you can size this down to fit your 4500 by 5400. There you go. Just make sure that it's inside and kind of centered, and you can use kind of those guides for being centered. And there you go, that's done. I'm gonna export it like this, export. PNG, of course, make sure it's 4500 by 5400. It should be because we resized it. We're gonna export it here, and I'm gonna just call it Cruise. Well, I gotta spell this right, Cruise Squad. Boom, and hit save, and it's gonna save to your desktop or wherever you want it to go. I'm having it to my desktop, and you can see it's just perfect. When I click on it, you can see it's showing gray as the background because that's the transparent background, but I don't see any like things going on there, so it's perfect. And that's how you do it. All right, so that was one of the 4 different ones. This was actually the easiest one. The next one I'm gonna show you is, what do we do when there is just a t-shirt instead of a color? So a t-shirt actually has more than just the gray. It has like folds and stuff. I'll show you what to do. All right, so for the t-shirt one that we have here, you can see sometimes Ideogram, even though you say black background, because you put t-shirt design in there, sometimes it allows to put it on a t-shirt with some of these wrinkles and stuff. So this is what I would do. I would take the crop tool right here and then kind of crop it out. So you see I kind of cropped out that collar there. I'm coming in closer here and then double click. And then I'm just doing this, and this is mostly gray. And if we do the same trick with the levels in here, bring this past that spike there, you can see it turned everything black, and I can come down, bring in the white level like this, bring in the gamma for the colors like that. And that would work nicely. And then I'm gonna remember to select these two and merge visible. Again, you don't have to select those two, just merge visible. And we're gonna do it with that one. So let's get rid of these two, boom. And then come in here, layer, invert, right? Filters, colors, erase white paper, layer, invert again. And you can see it's perfect, and we just have to size it again. So resize canvas. Do these, you can see how fast this is. 4500, tab 5400, resize, and click on it to make sure that it's everything's in and not getting cut off. So there you go. It doesn't have to be all the way to the bottom, but it's nice to give yourself the biggest size so that when you come into Affinity or when you come into Amazon or Redbubble or wherever you're putting this, that you have the right size. And kind of eyeball this circle. So this space should be equal to that space, and you can kind of eyeball it, you know, like that. Doesn't have to be perfect, but you know, that and that should be about the same. And make sure that nothing is over the edge here. You can kind of bring it down if you want to be safe. And then come back here and export again. 4500 by 5400, yes, export, and then call this whatever. I'm gonna just call it trainer and hit save, and we did another one. So I'm gonna show you all of these on t-shirts on Amazon just so you can see how it looks on a t-shirt. But let me do 2 more so that you can see all of them. The next one that I'm gonna do is one where there's lots of different colors on there. And so what do we do? Even if we bring the black up, it might not work. So I'm gonna show you some trick that I do on those. All right, so here's one where it is kind of a different color, right? So it's even more different than the t-shirt one. This one, the t-shirt one had kind of had gray and dark gray, but this is kind of like a light gray. So this is what I'll do for these. So I'm gonna zoom in here so you can see. Sometimes it's even up here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my brush here. So you can see I'm clicking on the brush here. And you notice the brush by default, it's black right here, 000. But I'm gonna take the eyedrop tool and make it this color, the main color right there. And then click on this again so it gives you that. You can see it right there. And now my brush is that dark gray. And I'm just gonna use the brush to kind of gray everything out, so it's one color again, so that we can go and use that. Now, if you have something like right there or inside, like smaller, you can make your brush smaller by pressing the parentheses, the outside parentheses, the left parentheses, and make it smaller, and the right parentheses make it bigger, right? So you can come in here, and if there is something in the middle there, you could do that. But I like to make it pretty big here and kind of make sure that I cover everything. Now, let's see if it gets close. Yeah, so if it gets close to a letter, you can kind of get slower here and move all of these out here. And it just takes a little bit more time. Some of them may actually be right on the letter, and so you got to be really close with your brush to kind of just touch the letter a little bit. And then not anything else, right? So let's do up here. It doesn't take too long, actually. The bigger your brush, the easier it is. But you may need a little brush for some of them that get really close to the artwork. Whoops. All right, so I think I did it. And so we're gonna follow the same steps that we did before. Now that this is gray and not black, right, we're gonna adjust the levels, come in here, levels. You see that spike right there, I'm gonna move it past the spike. I'm gonna come back and with my white level here and then move my gamma down a little bit just so that those colors, you don't have to be the exact same colors as they were before, but you want them to kind of be bright, or maybe you don't, maybe you want them kind of muted, and that's fine too. I'm gonna close this levels. You're gonna see I can right click on here. That's what I was doing, I didn't tell you. Right click on here for merge visible, and you're gonna see it's gonna merge these two together. And the reason why I like doing both is that it puts it on the top. So there you go. That's black now, right? So I'm gonna do, make sure you select this first. Layer invert, filters, colors, erase white paper, layer invert again. And there you go, it cuts it out perfectly. It's so much better than what we saw that Ideogram did early on. And we're gonna make the, resize this, make sure that center, unlock that, do 4,500, tab 5,400, hit resize. You can see it's pretty good. I'm gonna zoom out so you can see, and it fits, right? And is kind of close to that. Maybe I want it just a little bit this way, I don't know. It kind of looks, actually, I think it was right. All right, so I'm gonna export this and call this ramen. All right, last one. What happens if there's a word that AI does that shouldn't be there? Maybe they put the wrong word in there or whatever. So I'm gonna show you an example of that. All right, so here it is. You can see it was supposed to say, I'm my family's unpaid tech support, but it did it twice. I'm my family's unpaid tech support. Now I could erase this one and just have this on the top and just say, I'm my family's unpaid tech support. Or I could erase this middle one, which would be a little more difficult because I'd have to erase that and then move everything up instead of just erasing that. I'll show you the more difficult one. But the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do the levels thing again. So we're gonna do that. Make sure that we have a black background. Make sure this is there. That's great. I like selecting these two and hit merge visible. Remember that was right click to see those. And then I can get rid of these two by just selecting them and hitting delete. And I can come in here and hit invert and come in here, colors, remove or erase white paper. Do this invert again. Now, if I wanted it black on white, I could have just left that invert, right? So this could be on a white t-shirt. So I could have actually do two if I wanted that. But I'm gonna show you how, just when it's white here. So I'm gonna remove this part. And the way to do that is you can see this lasso, but it can also be a tool, the rectangle tool. And I'm gonna go like this over it. Make sure this is selected, and I just hit delete, and that's gone. But we have this space here, so I'm gonna have to move this up. So again, I'm gonna do the rectangle tool, it's already there, and I'm gonna select this whole thing, and I'm gonna go to my move tool, this one right here, and I'm just gonna pull it up. There you go. That's how you do it. So that's the easy way to do it. There may be words that are too much to the right or too much to the left, and you gotta move things around, but you can use the lasso tool or any of these right here to select the thing that you want to remove and select the thing that you want to move as well. And that's what this is for. And now we just have to do one more thing. Remember, resize the canvas, come in here, do 4,500 by 5,400, resize, and make sure that this is the right. I'm gonna zoom out, click on here or here, and click on these handles to make sure that it fits all in there. And I think it does nicely. We're just gonna make sure that it's centered. I'm just eyeballing it, but you can do that. All right, so file, export, make sure it's 4,500 by 5,400. And I'm just gonna call it unpaid. All right, so we did those four. And I wanna just show you one last thing, how it looks like on t-shirts, so you don't see the gray background, you don't see any other things, and how clean it is doing it this way as opposed to just trying to remove the background in the AI itself. All right, so here we are on Amazon Merch on Demand. I'm just gonna drop these in here one at a time just so we can see what it looks like on a t-shirt and see how clean it is without the background. So the first one was Cruise Squad. I'm gonna put that in here. It may take a little while. I'll jump ahead so that you can see what it looks like. All right, so here's Cruise Squad. You can see the background is knocked out and it works great on all these colors. Look at that, right? So some of the colors will not be great because of just the lightness of the background, but you can see on most of the dark backgrounds, that's gonna be just fine. And there's no other kind of things in the background. It's all knocked out, even the letters, in between the letters and everything, even in between the vintage sunset, it's knocked out. So the next one was, I think my trainer is trying to kill me. Look at that. Look how nice that is. Even in between, again, the vintage sunset and in these here where it's the shadow, it works really well, right? Super cool. All right, we'll do another one. Now this is the ramen one. I chose the ones with vintage sunsets because a lot of times it's hard to get those in-betweens to remove the background, but you can see it did it really well. Look at all these in these different colors too. Pretty cool, right? And lastly, let's do the one where I move the words out. And there you go. And this is actually a good way to test it. So if you see any artifacts, like if you erase stuff, with your design and you notice some things here, you can actually go back and go with the erase tool or whatever to delete it. And I actually didn't show the erase tool, but you can use the erase tool to remove. We use the marquee with the rectangle, but same thing, you could come in here and if there's some little things, you can come in and erase it. But you notice all of these are great. In my family's unpaid tech support. I'm my family's unpaid tech support, and it works great on all of these colors. There you go. So that's how it works out, and it's so easy to do if you have Affinity Photo. So there you go. That's how to help out with some tricky backgrounds. If you haven't seen my original one, it's on my channel where we just remove the black background. But if you've done these, I kind of did the black background too. So it's basically the end part of what you did. If you haven't seen the video about ideogram and the batches and how to create so many different designs that will show you some of these backgrounds, I'll put that video right here. It's really cool. I've been using it this whole month to create lots and lots of designs. And you can see these AI designs from Ideogram are really cool. They can do vintage sunset and cool text and all of that stuff. So hopefully that's helpful for you too. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.